Hello folks, so we are now going to create a geodesic domicile of Blender version 2.82a, as you can see over here. So let's get started by first destroying the first cube we're starting out with, because everyone does it and we have to too. So inside of mesh, go to IQ sphere, choose that, and of course I want a little bit more definition, so I'm gonna add subdivisions to number 3. Now I'm going to go to edit mode in the side view, select faces and x-ray, because I want to select all of these faces, destroy them like everything else in our lives, and then we're going to go to edges. Go away from the x-ray mode and select every edge, because we are now going to bevel these things. I can press the right button, Control B to bevel, that would be fine. Now go back to faces and go back to side view, x-ray, and destroy these faces because I don't need them anymore. The only reason why I kept them is that I wanted this actual ring of faces, and we wouldn't have gotten them if we would have done it the other way. Now go to vertices and I'm going to select the bottom row, go destroy them by just pressing Control X, you know, dissolve them instead of just pressing X and then dissolve from the menu, because that's stupid and takes much more longer. So now with these selected, done, I'm going to select one of these edges, faces actually. This is a face, not an edge, I know that. And instead of just selecting every single face on this model, because there's a lot of them and it would take a lot of time, and I don't want to do that, so I'm just going to press Shift G to select similar and choose polygon side. So every polygon that has the exact same amount of sides as that selected one, as you can see, equal to the amount of sides, everything else we're going to get selected. And with these selected, I'm going to press Alt E to get this extrude menu and choose extrude along normals. Can do it as well from this menu over here, but it takes much more longer and I don't want to do that. So I'm now gonna invert a selection and then Control minus on the numpad, so I just select the outer faces. I'm gonna bevel these as well, that will be fine. Perfect. Now we are going to get a little bit more nicer. First I want to create a plane. If I can select the right thing, scale this plane a lot and then go back to the dome, select one of the faces again, Shift G, polygon sides, and now go to the materials pane and add a new material. This is going to be a little bit like bluish, and go to the material preview, everything is blue, I don't want that, so select all of these again, invert selection, and then create a new material, assign that to the outer edges, and then something like brownish to make like, you know, wood color. Alright, so now I want to actually select all of these guys and polygon sides, that would be great, and as well as this guy, polygon sides, Control plus, because I want to have these faces over here, create another material, assign this to everything. This is gonna be a metallic material, a little bit less roughness, and then all of these guys, actually I want to select them and add this material to them. Now as you can see, this has 6 sides, this has 5 sides, so I want to actually keep them like that. And also the normals is a little bit, actually it could work, I don't mind that too much. That's good. So now we have our geodesic dome, perfect, right? I hope you learned something. That's basically it, you know. There is one more thing actually I can show you by just deleting this light and creating a new light. And go to light, and I want to have an area light. Select this guy. Now, if I select the light and then the dome, and then go to F3 and of course search for track or make track, and then track to constraint, then this little thing is going to be always pointing towards the dome, which is a really nice trick that I picked up. So if I now go to the light, if I select this light and say 4,000, make it a lot bigger, inside here I want to choose the cycles, and here you have it, just make it a little bit further away, and here you have your pretty dome. Now if you want to, we can actually go and duplicate this thing, scale it down, and this guy is going to be having Now if I go over here, select one of these guys, Shift G, select everything with this material. If I want to do that as well, I can create a new material, assign that, and make this like green. Perfect. And because I'm stupid and crazy, I want to have another one. I want to go over here, scale it a little bit down, move it again, something like this, and then duplicate this guy. There, perfect. We are going to select that guy, material, create a new one, assign, and then this guy's gonna be blue, and then this guy, material, assign another one, it's gonna really be yellow. And there you have it. Perfect little dome city. Actually, I want to have one material more, one extra material for the ground. Oops. The last one over here, and the ground is going to be a little bit like something like that. Cool, isn't that pretty? I hope you learned something. There you have it. Have a good day. Goodbye.